बर्बादियाँ तुमसे मिली है, आबादियाँ तुमसे मिली है। आई लव दिस सॉन्ग, आई कॉन्ट गेट ओवर इट। दिस इज ऑल्सो द सॉन्ग दैट आई एम हियरिंग ऑन लूप राइट नाउ। ओ बाय द वे, दिस सॉन्ग इज फ्रॉम द फिल्म शिद्दत, एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू रिव्यू द फिल्म शिद्दत। बट बिफोर दैट, हेलो एंड वेलकम, दिस इज श्रेयसी एंड यू आर वेलकम टू बॉलीवुड बग वंस अगेन। इफ यू आर न्यू टू द चैनल देन डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू इट एंड हिट द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डोंट मिस एनी नोटिफिकेशन वेन एवर वी अपलोड अ न्यू वीडियो। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो वेदर दिस फिल्म इज वर्थ वॉचिंग और इज इट जस्ट अनदर ब्लंट लव स्टोरी दैट यू कैन श्योरली मिस, देन कीप वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड। एंड नाउ लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। शिद्दत इज अ लव ड्रामा फिल्म दैट इज डायरेक्टेड बाय कुणाल देशमुख एंड प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मैडॉक फिल्म्स एंड टी सीरीज। द फिल्म हैज़ प्रेमियर्ड ऑन डिज्नी प्लस हॉटस्टार ऑन 1st of October एंड इन द लीड रोल्स यू विल गेट टू सी सनी कौशल, ब्रदर ऑफ विकी कौशल, नाम तो सुना ही होगा, एंड राधिका मदान। मोहित रायना एंड डायना पेंटी प्ले द सेकेंड लीड्स इन द फिल्म। Now firstly let me give you a synopsis of the film. The film starts with Ira and Gautam's wedding. Gautam being Mohit Raina and Ira being Dina Penty. Now in their wedding, Joginder aka Jaggi, the role played by Sunny Kaushal, gate crashes with his friends. Obviously later Jaggi got kicked out of the wedding after Gautam found out the truth. But what did not kick out of Jaggi's mind is Gautam's wedding speech which he said dedicating his wife. Later in his life, Jaggi meets this girl Kartika, the role played by Radhika Madan, at a sports club where Jaggi used to go for playing hockey while Kartika used to go for practicing swimming for some random swimming race event. From day one, Jaggi was acting over smart, clicking and posting pictures with her without her permission. And then posing naked in front of Kartika and her friend with equal confidence as Johnny Sins. I know, bad reference, but that's true. Later, Jaggi also body shames Kartika because of her overweight and states that she could only win the race if she loses her weight. And you know what she did in return? She scolded him for 30 seconds in the morning and at night she went partying with the same guy who body shamed her in the morning. And that's not all, because after that same party, Kartika chose to kiss Jaggi and then ended up sleeping with him. The next morning, Kartika wins her race and Jaggi loses his mind. Why? Because he finds out that Kartika is getting married to someone else, which she did not inform about before sleeping with him. So, Kartika says a sweet but meaningless sorry to him for what she did with him. And do you know what he did in return? Sang Yamma Yamma in front of everyone for her. What an emotionally messed up wala love. Cut to 3 months later when Jaggi is trying to illegally travel from India to London without any passport or money. Now I know that this film is all about doing crazy stuff for love. But who does such crazy stuff for the girl who made it very clear that she was fine with the one night stand but she can't pursue him anymore? I have just one verdict for you, Jaggi. You brought all your luggage with yourself but you forgot one thing, your brain. So while Jaggi was trying to enter France illegally, he got caught and that is when he met Gautam once again. Gautam, instead of taking the decision of sending Jaggi back home immediately, he chose to explain to him that his Shiddat Wala love philosophy has changed and he has bloody faced the reality of a relationship after getting married. Well, ye to hona hi tha. But this time Jaggi did not get inspired by Gautam's philosophy and he did everything, he tried to run away every time and however he could to reach Kartika, who on the other side is very happy making arrangement for her wedding. But then Kartika receives a phone call from Jaggi and that's when she started facing all the confusions. That's when she started thinking, oh, I had a guy named Jaggi whom I used to like and what will I do if he shows up on my wedding? Shall I cancel my wedding? Shall I not? And all of that. Whether Jaggi reaches his destination and meets Kartika or not, well, you have to find out in the film. Now let me talk about the direction and screenplay of the film. Director Kunal Deshmukh made a pretty good attempt at delivering a classic Laila Majnu love story with modern day complications and situations. The film makes you laugh, feel and cry along with the characters, which is a good thing. Also, the characters have been framed in a way that you can easily relate to them. The script of the film has been written by Dheeraj Ratan, Pooja Lata Surti and Srihar Raghavan. The script, according to me, could have either stuck to being realistic or vaguely imaginary. But the fact that throughout the film it was way beyond logics and then at the end it chose to give a very realistic touch did not really work well for me. So if I have to rate the screenplay and direction of this film, I'll give it a 4 on 5. I'll cut 1 marks because of that realistic yet illogical end of the film. Now, if I have to talk about acting, Vicky Kaushal's brother Sunny Kaushal is equally talented as his elder brother. And this was clear from his acting in the film. Whether it is about emoting the real emotions of the character of Jaggi or delivering dialogues in a convincing manner, Sunny managed to hold our attention throughout the film with his acting skills. The portrayal of a happy-go-lucky character is so adorable, honestly, and you can easily relate to his character and feel his emotions. Speaking of Radhika Madan, she also did quite a good job in terms of acting. She managed to bring out the confusions of the character of Kartika quite well. You can actually relate to her character and the dilemmas that she faces when she has to choose between logic and emotion. But if you ask me, the way she delivers her dialogue remains same almost throughout the film, whether she is angry or she is sad. So I think her dialogue delivery is quite blunt, to be honest. Mohit Raina did an excellent job in the role of Gautam, as is expected from him. His monologues are just a treat to the ears. The heavy voice, the intense look, the strong dialogue delivery, his smile. I mean, everything about Mohit Raina's acting is worth loving. So all you Mohit Raina fans out there, you will love watching him in this film. On the other hand, Diana Penty did not have much of a screen presence, and honestly, even when she was shown in the film, she did not make any impact with her presence. Now, talking about the dialogues in the film. The dialogues in the film has been written by Pooja Lata Surti, and some of the dialogues are surely worth remembering. Like the monologue given by Mohit Raina on the importance of Shiddat in love. Well, that's quite impactful, to be honest. Or the fun one-liners given by Sunny Kaushal, like, friend tu apne mangetar ko banana, main to love hu. I know completely illogical, but very cute. Why don't I get to hear such things? Oh, such guys only exist in the films, yeah. My bad. Now about the songs and the music in the film. The title track Shiddat Banalu is quite soulful, to be honest. There is some kind of a passion in the voice of Manan Bharadwaj which will just touch your heart. Not to forget, this song also summarizes the whole theme of the film very effectively. Next up is Barbadia Abadia, my favorite song. Trust me, you will feel like dancing to it immediately. The music by Sachin and Jigar is quite catchy, and I'm sure that this song is going to be played in almost every party this season. Next up is Hamdam, a song sung by Ankit Tiwari. Of course, his voice is a treat to the ears. Like dripping rains, a cup of coffee and this song, and you will be all set to have a romantic date with yourself. Come on, yeah, it's not weird. You should try a self-date sometime. Anyways, next up there is also a song named Akhiya Udek Diya, which is sung by Master Saleem. Of course, he sung it very beautifully, and it's also another song that you can hear on loop. So my overall rating on the music, background score and the songs of the film is a 5 on 5. Now let's talk about the cinematography of the film. The cinematography has been done by Amalindu Chaudhary, who I think did a pretty good job behind the camera. From the close-up shots highlighting the real emotions of the characters on their faces to the panoramic shots highlighting the locations, everything has been shot so aesthetically that it will mesmerize the audience. Even the intimate scenes are shot very aesthetically and there is no vulgarity in it, you know. One thing I really liked are those shots where the truck is traveling through the road on one side of the screen and the map, showing the locations that are being covered by the truck are shown on the other side of the screen. I think it's very innovative. I have not seen something like this before, so I really liked it. And now it's verdict time. Those of you who like to watch love stories with or without logic, I think this film is absolutely perfect for you. Also, I have to admit that this film is like a breath of fresh air on an OTT platform after too many crime-based and sex-based stories. Good acting, great music, amazing locations, there are quite a few things about this film that you will really like. But I personally cannot take that illogical crap that I'll do anything illogical for my in-my-head girlfriend, even if in return I don't even get a piece of... Only if you know what I mean. So overall, this film is good for a one-time watch. So whenever you are free, you can sit with a bowl of popcorn and enjoy this Romeo-Juliet love story with a tarka of modern-day emotional dilemma. So I will give this film a 4/5. I was actually going to give a 3/5, but then I gave 1 brownie points for Mohit Raina's presence. Banta hai yaar. But for now, what you can give me is a big thumbs up if you like this video. Also, let me know in the comment section if you agree with my review or not. But before you go, let me tell you that you can check out my trailer review of the upcoming film Rashmi Rocket by clicking on the video here. You can also check out the real-life Indian athletes on whose lives Rashmi Rocket is based by clicking the video here. I'll see you in the next review video. Till then, it's me, Shreyashi, signing off.